here with Devontae Wilson from the Cougar Track and Field Team. Devontae is the Athlete of the Week after just putting together a really good performance despite some tough conditions at Valparaiso this week. Devontae, before we get to talking about your performance this week, tell us a little bit about yourself.
So my name is Devontae Wilson. I'm from Junction City, Kansas. I graduated from Junction City High School, and I am a junior right now, but in athletics, I'm a sophomore. But
now,
go ahead.
Talk about this week. I mean, I said it right early, but those conditions were not easy for any sporting event. But needless to say, you guys put together a first place in the 4x1, you take second in the 100, and then you do very well in the long jump. Mm-hmm. What was kind of the mindset despite the weather for you this week?
To be honest, I mentally prepped before the meet, and in my mind, I already won the long jump. And I made sure that I was mentally prepped way beforehand. So whenever I kept on hearing people complain about, you know, oh, yeah, it's too cold, it's too windy, oh, it's raining. In my head, I was like, oh, that's my advantage. I'm going to do good. You're talking about all these conditions that's going to make you do bad. I'm going to think about all the reasons why I'm going to do better.
And where do you get that kind of mindset from?
To be honest, I've been reading this book, and it's called With Winning in Mind. And it's about someone who won an Olympic gold medal, and he was a rifleman, and he won worlds and everything. And then he's basically talking about a process in a life that he's living and that he's teaching from that. And I'm like, a lot of it you could apply to in life and definitely athletics.
Are you able to kind of impart some of that knowledge on your teammates? Because obviously you guys did really good in the 4x1 as well. And that's as team as it gets, because you need to trust your teammates, especially with the handoffs and everything, in one of the fastest, most exciting races in track and field.
So what I basically try to pass down to my teammates is, you know, trust me, I'm going to get the baton to you. No matter how bad the start may be, I'm going to make sure that I pass it off. All you got to do is take care of your part, and I'll make sure I take care of mine.
And how do you mentally, you say you mentally prepped before, but knowing that you have a couple events with multiple rounds to it, the long jump, the 4x1, and the 100, to be able to be mentally ready to have such a long kind of grind of a day?
So what I do is usually I visualize me having a great start, and I make sure that I warm up and I'm good to go. So by the time that we got to take off our warm-ups and everything, I'm warm. And in the book, it taught us this thing about, you know, you'll see a lot of athletes in the Olympics, you know, you'll see them yawning, but they're not tired. What they do is they yawn to help their, it'll help their body relax. And so I'll fake yawn and end up really yawning. And it helps me relax, keep my mind calm and everything. And all I do is visualize, okay, Devontae, it is like you to win. And I keep saying that in my head. It is like me to win. And then what happens in the race or in the jump, I usually end up top two or I win it.
Well, we'd like to congratulate you on a fantastic week. And we're going to get you with a little bit of rapid fire in the hot seat to get to know you just a little bit better.
Yes, sir.
Your favorite color?
Pink.
Your favorite food?
Gumbo.
Ooh. Southern boy.
Oh, yes, sir.
Favorite sports team?
Saints.
Someone who you look up to and why?
My mom, because she was always there regardless of how hard times got.
Who can make you laugh the best on the team?
I would have to say it's Leroy.
Any good appropriate stories?
Not at the moment.
And best or most funny coach moment from any of your coaches here at CUC?
Oh, I have to say Coach Phil. Really funny guy.
He comes up with some stuff.
Yes, really funny.
Congratulations on a fantastic week. Keep up the good work as you guys head into conference, and hopefully we can have you back in here again real soon.
Oh, thank you.